This movie will introduce the concept of sets, and it will introduce some counting techniques that are useful when you're categorizing objects. Here's an example of a set. Sets are commonly denoted with the capital letter of the alphabet. This set is named capital B. The set has four objects that make up the set. These are called the elements of the set. This set has four elements consisting of the four people, Bob, Mary, Sue, and Ellen. These curly brackets are used frequently to denote a set, the elements of the set being listed inside the curly brackets. This is a symbol that means is an element of, so you read this expression as Bob is an element of the set B. This is the negation of that symbol. Bob is an element of B. Elizabeth is not an element of the set B. Elizabeth is not one of the elements that constitutes the set. This is a set named A. It consists of five elements, the whole numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 4 is an element of the set A. It is one of the five things listed when we list the elements of A. 17 is not an element of A. Another way to describe the set A would be to say set is the set of all things which satisfy the condition that the thing is an integer and is between 0 and 6. In the first description of the set A, we have simply listed the elements of A. In the second description of the set A, we have described a condition that has to be met in order to belong to A, the set of all things X which satisfy the condition that X is an integer and X is bigger than 0 and less than 6. In this example, the set A is the days of the week, the seven elements Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We could also describe the set A by saying that the set A consists of all things X which satisfy the condition that X is one of the days of the week. A subset of a set is a part of a set. If A is the set consisting of these five letters, lowercase a, b, c, d, and e, and capital B is the set consisting just of D and B, then B is a subset of A because all the elements of B are also elements of A. The notation that's used for subsets is the symbol shown right here. You look at this expression and you read it by saying B is a subset of A. Every set is a subset of itself. For example, suppose capital A is the set consisting of the four numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. And suppose B is the set including the numbers 2, 3, and 4. Then certainly B is a subset of A because every element of B is included in the elements of A. But A is also a subset of A because, the same reason, every element of A is included among the elements of A. The empty set has a special symbol. The symbol is shown here. It's the set with no elements. And for a rather vacuous reason, the empty set has to be viewed as being a subset of every set. Any element of the empty set is included in any other set simply because the empty set doesn't have any elements. Let's list all the subsets of the set capital A whose elements are the numbers 1 and 2. We can take all the elements, in other words, the set A itself, that's a subset. We could take just the number 1 and form the subset consisting of that element alone. We have a subset consisting of the number 2 alone. Or we have the empty set. So these four sets shown are all the sets that qualify as being subsets of the set whose name is capital A. In this example, A is the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and B is the set consisting of the numbers 2, 3, and 4, and we have a number of statements we're going to consider to see whether the statements are true or false. The first statement says B is a subset of A. That's true, and all we have to do is observe that every element of B is included as an element of A. The next statement says 0 is an element of A. That's certainly true because 0 is one of the elements listed when we're listing the elements of the set A. The third statement says 0 is a subset of A. That's false. 0 is not a set. 0 is a number. To be a subset of A, first off, something has to be a set. Statement 4 says the set consisting of the number 0 and that number only is a subset of A. That's true because every element of this set, there's only one, it's the number 0, every element of this set is included among the elements of A. Statement 5 says the empty set is an element of A. That's false. All the elements of A are numbers. The empty set is not a number. It's certainly not one of the ones listed as the elements of A. Statement 6 says the empty set is a subset of A. That's true. The empty set is a subset of every set. Statement 7 says the empty set is a subset of B. That's true for the same reason. The empty set is a subset of every set, including the set B. In many discussions, it's convenient to have a universal set from which all the other sets draw their elements. In this example, the universal set is denoted by U, and it includes all the numbers from 1 to 10, and the particular subset of U that we're considering here is the set A, which includes the numbers 2, 5, 6, 7, 9, and 10. The complement of a set is a concept that relates to the universal set, because the complement of a set refers to all the elements in the universal set which are not in the set under consideration. The complement of the set A would be all the things in the universal set which do not belong to A. The notation is we write A with a little superscript of C to represent A complement. A is these elements in the universal set. The complement of A would be all the other elements in the universal set, the things in the universal set which are not included in the set A, which in this case are 1, 3, 4, and 8. So keep in mind that the concept of the complement of a set is meaningful only when you're talking about some universal set in the background. Let's review the set notation that we've gone over so far. We have the membership symbol. X is an element of A, or X belongs to A. We have a symbol that negates that. X does not belong to the set A. We have the subset symbol. We have a symbol for the empty set, the set with no elements. We consider the empty set to be a subset of every set. And when we're having a discussion of sets in the context of some universal set, then the complement of set is all the things in the universal set that don't belong to the set we're talking about. Here we have three sets that are described by a condition. The first set in part A, to belong to the set, something has to satisfy the property that it's an integer and strictly between 3 and 9. The second set is described by the condition that an element must be a letter and be included in this word. And the third set is described by the condition that to be an element of the set, something has to satisfy this equation. For the first set, described by the condition an element must be an integer and between 3 and 9, if we list the elements of that set, they are the numbers 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Remember, integers are whole numbers, so there are only 5 of them. The second set, where the elements have to be letters and belong to the word escalate, would include the set of letters E, S, C, A, L, and T, because those are all the letters that appear in this word. And the third set, the set of things which are solutions to this equation, to belong to that set, you have to be a number that has the property that you square it, add 9, and you get 25. And the only two numbers that have that property are the numbers 4 and minus 4. So in order to list the elements of this set, we have to solve that quadratic equation. Which of the following sets are equal? The set A consists of the two elements, 2 and minus 2. The set B is all numbers that satisfy this equation. C is also described by an equation. D is the set of numbers that are integers and satisfy a certain inequality. And E is described by listing the elements. Which of these sets are equal? The solution is that A, C, and E are all the same. Let's see why that's true. A has these two elements. E has the same two elements. They're listed in a different order, but sets don't really have any order attached to them. It's the same set of objects. So that's why A and E are the same. And the reason that C is the same is because the numbers 2 and minus 2 are the only numbers that satisfy this equation. So A, C, and E are identical sets, simply described in different ways. B and D, each of those sets, is the set consisting of the number 2 and nothing else. 2 is the only number that satisfies the equation x plus 1 equals 3, so 2 is the only element of the set B. And similarly, 2 is the only integer that lies strictly between 1 and 3, so it's the only element that makes up the set D.